Welcome to the Council on Foreign Relations. This is the Election 2020 series.
This is human trafficking and its security implications.
Good evening and welcome.
Welcome to the University of New Hampshire.
This meeting is on the record.
This meeting is on the record, and of course, the internet never forgets.
2020 started off with its share of global challenges, high-stakes elections, and more.
Operating under that broader definition of the role of foreign affairs, what impact have you seen so far from the killing of General Soleimani and the aftermath?
As always, the Council on Foreign Relations provided a trusted forum for discussing and debating these international issues.
We are taking up one of the great debates of our age.
The idea here is not to get into partisan politics, it is to discuss foreign policy challenges.
Can we come up with an agenda to reform the World Trade Organization?
But with the sudden onset of a global health crisis, the world had to adapt, and so did we.
75% of all the new infections that afflict mankind are zoonotics. They come from an animal to a human, which is exactly what this coronavirus did.
In public health, we have principles of risk communication. Be first, be right, be credible.
At a time when reliable information, opinions, and guidance were needed more than ever, the Council rose to the challenge. By shifting from in-person meetings to virtual, we've been able to expand our reach and grow our global audience.
We have 670 members joining this conversation.
Over 500 people registered for this virtual meeting.
Participants from 43 states.
We'll try to get as many questions as possible.
In response to the election, growing social justice movements, and the COVID-19 pandemic, the Council launched a series of new events.
I'm delighted to be here. It's kind of fun, this idea of a master class.
And continued our partnership with educators, journalists, religious leaders, and state and local officials.
There was a huge Black Lives Matter demonstration under the Eiffel Tower. There was a huge Black Lives Matter demonstration outside the British Houses of Parliament. And these were all prompted by the murder of an American citizen on American soil by an American cop. And, you know, the world is watching.
Anti-Black and brown racism is not unique around the world. So there is a sort of international solidarity that we see.
And machine values are human values. And under that premise, it really speaks to the core of what we hope AI could bring to humanity.
2020 has been a year unlike any other, and challenges still lie ahead.
Think that the only way Brazil is going to take the Amazon issue seriously is when the agribusiness is in danger of being hurt.
We'll continue to see slowing workforce growth because of aging, unless we dramatically improve skills training, early childhood literacy, and secondary educational attainment.
Humans are incredibly innovative, and while we may not catch up with Mother Nature, we can still find ways to learn and experiment and innovate, even under these very, very trying times.
As it has for 100 years, the Council will continue to offer a crucial platform for nonpartisan information on the foreign policy issues that shape our world.